Hey there, everybody. It is Steve Brossman from the Entrepreneurs Locker Room, and have I got a treat for you guys today. I've got a special, super special guest. In fact, I think he's the first person ever to come back three times. Alan Stevens, internationally renowned profiling and communications expert and specialist. Great to see you again, buddy.
Thanks very much. And back for the third time, it's because I just won't go away.
Yeah. Look, I think we haven't really spoken. It's been a little while since. We haven't really spoken since you were flown at the pointy end of the plane over to London to be the guest speaker at the Star Wars Rogue One premiere. I mean, how cool is that?
It wasn't actually the premiere itself, but it was a joint venture they were running, and they needed somebody to explain the stories the face tells before you utter a single word. And that was being interviewed by the world's press that they flew in from all over the world. So that was really special.
In fact, that's probably even more impressive. Yeah, the premiere, they just have the wannabe celebrities walking down the carpet,
that's right.
But they chose you out of all the people around the world to fly you in to talk to all the other people around the world. And that's just an insight for you guys that are watching this right now, how internationally regarded Alan is in what it is that he does. And in the next 10 minutes or so, we're going to give you a snippet of who he works with and how he works with different people. The first one really excites me because it's for sales professionals, professionals who want to learn how to have a better relationship with their prospects and their clients and be able to sell better and grow their business. So, Alan, tell us, how do you do that?
Well, pretty simply, it's all about being able to read another person, to understand them, to talk to them in the way that they need to be spoken to. You'll have your way of you like to speak. I have mine. We have the same, or we have different ways that we all have of how we take information and how we process it. But we will always talk to the other person the way that we want to be spoken to. And if you happen to be analytical like me and the other person is just wants the overview, the least amount of information, I'll need a lot of information to make a decision. So I will give them a lot of information. And I will talk to the point where I've got the sale and I'll keep talking and I'm out of the sale. I've gone straight out the back door because I've given them far too much. But if I can recognize and understand their personality traits, in that moment, I know exactly how to present to them. I can even pick up exactly how they like to buy, whether they're focused on the value or the service. So I know straight away from just seeing their face without asking a single question, exactly how to speak to them.
And that's a real secret weapon, and it's an ethical one because it also provides greater value and a greater service to be able to get to the heart of what that person really wants and give them the right information, service them better, again, so they're actually getting greater value. What's some of the different things that you've seen with people that they were possibly going down the wrong way, potentially losing a sale, but turned it around and made such a difference?
Well, the first thing is that you teach it, you know, very well to people is that you build that relationship, you understand them. So you're not actually selling, you become a problem solver. Because as you said, you're looking at helping them save time, save money, make money, fix the emotional things that they, or get the emotional outcomes they're looking for, but also to solve their problem and to remove their worry and stress. If you do that, then you actually they'll make a purchase, but you haven't really sold anything. They buy from you. Most people go out and try and sell their products. So they're thinking about their product, not thinking about the person they're working with. So the more you can understand the other person, connect with them on their level, you're always going to get a greater response from them.
Yeah, that does resonate so much in the way that I teach things as well. And if you're not got that communication right, and it's almost like the two magnets, and you know, with the two magnets, and if you've got them one way, they're just going to get to that point and then just repel and repel. But you turn it around and you're having the person say, wow, that person gets me. They understand me because you're communicating how they want to be communicated to. You're going to get halfway through that conversation. It's just going to go, snap, I've got to work with you.
That's exactly what it's all about. So the sales always become quite effective. The sale will take the amount of time it needs to take. And the amount of time it needs to take is based on the other person's personality, how they like to process information, how they like to be treated. It's not a case of when it comes to respect and things, we want to treat others as we would have them treat us. But when it comes to communications and sales, It's speaking to the other person, treating them in a way in which they want to be treated, not the way that we want to be treated. So we change ourselves to match them. We're not changing our personality. We're just respecting them and connecting with them in the way that they need to be spoken to. And as you said, like the magnets, once they realize that, you're connected very quickly. They just snap to that position.
Unbelievable. That's just one group. Now, the other group that I'm hoping to chat to you about today is in the workforce. And there's lots of things going on in the workforce, and we know that sometimes it's not the most harmonious, and people need to have certain levels of conversation to bring it back in. How do you work with people in that way?
Well, again, we're looking now at the relationships within the organization. Since COVID, with a lot of people now working from home, one of the biggest turnovers in business was executive positions, because they didn't know how to manage the staff who weren't in the office. If they understand their staff, and especially when they're on video calls, yes, we can't pick up the micro expressions because the timing's a little bit out there with technology, but they understand the person, and through the body language, they can realize whether they've really connected with them. Have they got their message across? Because at the end of the day, the catch cry today is work on your business, not in your business. But you can't work on your business unless you've got people inside the business working in there. So you've got to have trust in them. So you've got to know how to build a relationship with them to where they feel that they belong, that they contribute, that they're valued, and they then want to work in the organization. So that when you're not there, the organization will not only survive, but it will grow as well. And that's the true definition of a boss.
Yeah, so what I'm hearing, and I've broken it down into something else that I'll get you to touch on, is that there's going to be a range of different conversations that need to happen. You might need to have a different conversation with this person, maybe whether it's to pull them in line, to give them some good information, to give them some good feedback. Mm-hmm. So there's the what and the who. By having the techniques that you teach people, you give them the how.
Yeah.
A lot of people focus on, okay, you got to have this conversation with this person. Mm. But if you don't do it the right way, it's actually probably going to blow up in your face. Explain a little bit about that.
Well, that's it. If you understand the person's personality, you know whether they take things personally, whether they've got a dry wit, all the different things. The face tells us everything we need to know. And if we can see that, then we can address them in that particular way. So we know the ones that are a little bit more emotional about things. We can change the way in which we speak to them. We'll have a way of phrasing it. We'll also the amount that we will actually express in there. If we've got somebody who is more robust, well, they're not going to respect us if we use the softer language. So we can use a more direct language with them, and they will respect that in turn. So it's finding the right language to use. And again, the face will tell us exactly how to do that.
Fantastic. Now, I wanted to keep this nice and short and bite-sized, but when you break it down, what we've just covered there is if you're somebody who is looking at external communications with your prospects, your clients, and people you want to work with in an external way, as well as how to have the right conversations with the people that are in your business and surround you, then you need to look at some of the processes and the programs that you have available. And I know that you've been helping people right across the planet, but across the different spectrum as to whether they're in a sales or a service approach, as well as the internal. Look, let them know exactly which is the best way to contact you, and then they'll be able to have a chat and work out what's the best next steps, Alan.
Well, if they want to have a bit of a look around and just get a bit more of a broad understanding, my website's probably the best place, and that is alanstevens.com.au. But if you really want to get to the point, you want to have a discussion and find out exactly what you need for yourself, you know, describe your situation and go, okay, Alan, how would I handle this? Then my email address is the best. Let's just jump into that and get into that conversation. And that's alan@alanstevens.com.au.
So I'm going to break it down. If you deal with humans, not animals or aliens, you really need to know how to do it the best way possible. Mm. And by knowing how they want to receive the information is a big step forward to be able to create those relationships, get more clients on board, and have a more profitable and productive workplace. One last comment, Alan, what do you want to leave us with?
Well, the one thing I want to leave you with is the fact that when it comes down to it, remembering that if you want to be able to sell your products and services, you have to be able to build a relationship first. So when people always say to me, what do I bring to the table? The only thing I've ever been able to give as an answer there is I bring the table. So remember, if you get the relationship right, you built the foundation right, you can build everything else up on top of it. You'll never get a chance to do that unless you share your products and services, unless you build the relationship first.
Mate, absolutely brilliant. Thank you again for coming back for the third time. I'm sure there will be a fourth coming up around the corner fairly soon. So if you really want to enhance the relationships with those that are coming to you and those that are working around you, jump in, have a chat with Alan, and I know that he can help you. Thanks, Alan. We'll see you all around real soon. Cheers.
Thank you.